What is up, YouTube? This is Vault here, back in today with you guys, another new Speedo Match 2 video. And today we are playing that many of you have requested for an update of this deck profile is Meteor B Dragon or Meteor Black Dragon. And today we're playing against the Drac deck right here in this duel right here. So yeah, once again, as always, if you guys want to see the new and updated deck profile, be sure to subscribe and hit that like button, comment down below that you guys want to see it, and as always, don't worry, the video will be posted a few days shortly after this video. And if you guys want to see it sooner, also, you know the drill, be sure to hit that like button. And if you guys can reach to 100 likes, I will release that deck profile video for you guys immediately. So always appreciate your support. So let's just go right into it right here. So we won our stone, paper, scissors. We want to go second as always, and the skill we're going to be playing is the fairly typical Christine right here with Fusion Party, because this skill did came out during of the special release of Trials of Kingdom. Some of you guys can play the Last Gamble Joey skill, or maybe the Palomization. That's totally up to you as well, but I like Christine the most because it gives you basically like an extra deck slot, which I will talk about in the deck profile, what I mean in terms of that. But you know, just getting an instant polymerization on sort of on the field access already, which is really, really great. So anyways, our opponents are setting their defenses and they're just gonna pass their turn right here. Immediately we have Summoner's Art. It's a great card to basically search up our fusion materials, and we're just gonna do Fusion Party right in the beginning, keeping the polymerization in our hand. Mostly we want to use the skill as soon as possible, utilize it, and then just keep cards on our hand for later resources to play and bring out Meteor B Dragon. Honestly, I think there's not going to be a huge difference by using polymerization or keeping the skill. It's totally up to you guys depending on the situation. Unlike Emma's skill where you search for ritual, you want to use that immediately. This one's a little bit different, so you kind of have the flexibility. I personally feel like it's a bit okay to use one or the other first without having to worry too much. But I did still kind of want to use the skill first for most cases. Anyways, so we got our double cross in right here, swinging for the attack, and we're going to swing in for massive damage right here if we can. And we do deal 3,500 damage to them, which is really good, and this is how powerful Meteor B Dragon is. So they're going to have to set for defenses, and it looks like we almost got game from here. So now we got Red Eyes Black Dragon. We just need another Meteor Dragon that we can draw into, and then we can basically summon another Meteor Black Dragon for more damage, so we can slowly just like collect our resources as we sit in the driver's seat at this point, you know, taking in the advantage of this game. We attack into their Stariko, and they're going to be summoning two tokens right here, and we just can get rid of them and see what they're going to do from here as well. And for now, there seem to be more defensive play, and they play Last Gamble. Okay, interesting. So, pretty interesting build. Pretty worth it for them as well, because they're only going to be paying like 400 life points, and they pitch two cards, and right here, they roll into a six. Wow, what a comeback. And you guys know me with Last Gamble. I think it's really, really cool. It's a pretty hit or miss skill, of course, that we all know for sure, hence that's why it's called. And when it works well, works really, really well. They play cost down right here, pitching a card from their hand, and they can basically tribute one monster to summon their Drac Tyrannus, because since now it's treated as a level 6 instead of a level 8, I believe. Oh no, sorry, level 5 instead of a level 7. So they're gonna bring out their boss monsters basically. And they're not gonna be strong enough to go over a Meteor Black Dragon anyways, but we're gonna Floodgate Trapple them. Just in case if they have anything like some equip spells or traps or something that they can actually counter onto our Meteor Black Dragon, which I am aware of, because fairly confident to bring out monster like that in attack already. Passing their turn, their Giraxa have very low defense, so it's easy even for a double cost and just to run over, which is great. Drew into our Meteor Dragon right here, so we can actually do another Meteor Black Dragon. We're not going to do that because we want to save it just in case for a follow-up play. If we lose our resources from here, and we're gonna swing in and see if we can get the game. Let's see, they have a Floodgate and a Kunai. Well, we're not really supposed to see that, honestly. But they actually use their Drac Herrer effect at this moment when we destroyed their Jirak Tyrannus with her double cross, and so they can bring back Jirak Hera right here, which is going to swing in for the attack and attack into Jirak Hera to go for game. And of course, like we said, we saw they have a Kunai right here. We can only see those cards, face down cards, only simply because it's a replay right here, but in the duel, we can't see them at all. So now they got the advantage back pretty much. I believe they normal summon that. Oh no, they special summon that, allowing us to special summon a monster from our graveyard as well. That's Gilosaurus' effect. Not too sure why, but I think they drew. Okay, so they basically want to go a little bit more stronger with power moves right here to bring out more of their Heras and swing in. So they do destroy our Meteor Black Dragon right here, and they do attack into our Red Eyes, leaving our double cost and vulnerable all by itself right here. So we're just gonna play our Polymerization and bring out our second Meteor Black Dragon. That's sort of what I meant with the follow-up play, I would say, just in case. But I guess I could have summoned it earlier to swing in for more damage or whatever, or maybe got game there, but I'm a little bit conservative sometimes with my plays. But it wouldn't have mattered anyways, because they do have Floodgate, and they put ours face down right here. And so we're gonna set and basically go into defense. It's our turn to be turtle right now and pass their turn, and they seem to have much more advantage right here. So they play Tail Swipe, which they have Jirak Hera, and basically they probably get their game right here, as well as playing Space Time Transcendence, which is a really cool deck card, I would say, to even play in this Jirak build, which I really, really like. And they go into defense, they're just playing around the Windstorm, I think, just in case. So they pretty much got the game in the bag right here, first game, right there. We're just gonna play the Dust Tornado, just to pop their cards so we can see what other cards they might be potentially playing, so we know. We'll take that damage, and yeah, they win. So they scored game one right here. So now side deck, moving to side deck. If you want to see the side deck, don't worry about it, guys. I will show you guys in the deck profile, so be sure to subscribe and stay tuned for that video to see what the side deck cards are here. And what did we really side against? We didn't really side much, honestly. I think we probably put in the Blast Held by Tribute, because we know that they do tribute summon quite a little bit here and there. And it makes total sense for a Jirak deck. That would be the major thought. Otherwise, yeah, that's really all we have to side in against this deck. So moving on to game two, and we're gonna show you guys how we're gonna come back from this. And once again guys, keep in mind that this is just a fun casual, you know, duel, really nothing too competitive. This deck is not as great as it was before, and not many people are actually playing it, but you know, still viable, still workable, as you guys can see for the cool style points, just to bring out Meteor Black Dragon overall. We do make them go first again, and then, you know, we'll set up our field and then attack into them again. Staurico with two tokens and passing our turn. End phase, we're just gonna, during their standby phase, we're just gonna Dust Tornado or whatever they have. We most likely want to hit the Floodgates, because Floodgates are just annoying to deal with overall. And we drew into Red Eyes. We're just gonna Tribute and summon one, and then just make sure we have a powerful monster. I'm just worried that if we keep our double costing the way it is on there, they can easily, you know, Tribute to summon a Hera and basically run over our double cost, and we should have nothing to sort of protect it with. Red Eye Spirit's really great for this deck as well, you know, just a great card to help bring back your Red Eyes Black Dragon after Fusion Summoning, the Recovery, which is really good for follow-up play as well. So we're just going to use Red Eyes Black Dragon for Beatdown right here. Since we don't have a Meteor Dragon, so we're not going to summon Meteor B yet, but finally we got one right here. And we're just going to go for it right here and summon our Meteor Black Dragon and try to swing for game. So, Floodgate Trapple is just crazily, insanely powerful in this current meta right now. It just stops any boss monsters that get summoned and basically renders them useless, which I really don't like thinking about it, because this card basically makes essentially all the other decks not as great as they really were. Because otherwise, if it weren't for Floodgate, I think this deck is probably pretty decent. Right here we'll attack with Red Eyes, and we're going to use Red Eye Spirit in the battle phase to bring it back, and then swing in here to see if we can take it for game. And they do have a Kunai, so they are surviving one more turn and not being able to take the game right here. Once again, they play their last gamble, and this time, let's see, they pitch off two cards again, and they roll off, and another six. Wow, what luck is this? And it's just insane when it really works out well for them, I just have to say, because now they have full cards to play with. They can play with anything. They're gonna go with their Space Time Transcendence, bring out 7, I guess. Yeah, Jirak Tyrannus with a level 3 Gilosaurus and a level 4 Hyper Hammerhead. That totally works. Totally good. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, that's good. And we're just gonna Floodgate it, because that's the strongest monster that we kind of know that they play in their deck. They're gonna special summon their Gilas for defenses and set some cards, I guess. So, we'll see. We're pretty good as well right here. We're just gonna start attacking to their monsters, destroying them. They bring out their Hera here, which is also really good. So we're just gonna swing into that Hera and yeah, pass our turn. There's nothing else we could really do but start running over their monsters. They summon Element Source and attack. Not sure why right here. Kind of baiting us. Maybe they have Kunai or something. Not too sure, but we're gonna be a little bit worried. We're gonna search our Meteor Dragon right here. And basically, whenever you draw into Summoner's Art, you just want to use it as soon as possible. So you thin down your deck, you get your resources. We're going to tribute that and just to summon the Meteor Dragon. Meteor Black Dragon is basically not even useful for us anymore at this point. So doing that was actually the right choice. And then let's see if we can swing in for game right here and attack. They play Kunai with Chain. And they basically game right there and chose to set that. Okay. It doesn't work out for them. They think we got the game there. So yeah, that basically rounds off the second game. Right here, once again, side deck. Be sure to check out that deck profile. That will be posted in a few days, so don't worry about it, guys. Be sure to subscribe and click that notification bell right here. Okay, so moving into game 3, and let's see who's gonna be better or which deck's gonna be stronger overall in the end. Of course, they're gonna want us to go first, so that's totally fine. And yeah. Cards don't look too good, but we do have two Floodgates, so we have nothing to worry about. We're gonna set our double cost and see how they play it out here. Dust Tornado, back row removal is essential almost. We're gonna flip up our double cost and swing it for some damage and see how it goes. They take it, which is great. We're pretty good set up for now. They have no monsters yet. We got our Summoner's Art. Unfortunately, we set up all the back row. Now we don't have anything to really play to play the Summoner's Art. Maybe I could have Dust Tornadoed so that we could have played the Summoner's Art, but maybe not either. You know, just in case we might want to Dust Tornado something important right here, which they do play Hera. We're gonna immediately Floodgate that no matter what, anyways, you know, because we can't run over it. Got our Blast out by a Tribute finally. Definitely a really, really good card. It's gonna work out very well for us. I should have played Summoner's Art first and then used Blast out by a Tribute, but I think during this time, I was thinking, oh, maybe I should save it, because just in case if I draw into Red Eyes Black Dragon or Meteor Dragon, I can immediately use Summoner's Art to search the other, basically. That's what I'm trying to do. So then I can basically immediately grant myself access to the Meteor Black Dragon. So I did mention earlier just now, it's best to use as soon as possible. Only you know what you have in your hand, I guess. Because the reason why I didn't want to use it here during that time was, let's say we use it here, and then we choose to search Red Eyes Black Dragon. During the next turn, we pop deck and draw another Red Eyes Black Dragon. And that's not good. I think that did kind of happen in the end, so I will show you an example of how it worked out. But anyways, yeah. Drawing lots of back row removal cards and back row cards. So we do manage to dust away the Floodgate for sure. We're gonna set the other Dust Tornado and just keep swinging in and see how we can do. We want to get rid of their back row, and here they're gonna use their skill Last Gamble once again, pitching two cards and rolling the dice. This time not as lucky as they were. They only got two cards, but two is okay to recover for what you have, because they were still able to play. As you can see, we're basically just doing double cost and beatdown at this point. No Meteor Bee Dragons being summoned at all, because we can get our Red Eyes Black Dragon, we can't get our Meteor Dragon. And yeah, right here we attack and destroy the Stariko. So Stariko allows them to bring out two tokens along with Jirak Hera back from the graveyard, which is really good as well. And we can't Floodgate that because I believe it is during the damage step of all of this happening. So that's basically it, just so you guys know. But that's fine with us, I think. We kind of need them to tribute summon a monster so then we can actually blast help by attribute them. And we can't Blast Hell by Tribute that, because I believe Jirak Hera was, you know, since it was Special Summon, we can't Blast, yeah, Blast Hell by Tribute is not going to work on that. They're going to attack straight in right here. So they're forcing us to use the Dust Tornado. We have one, so we are going to. We're going to force out that Dust Tornado, because with them being that confident swinging into us, that means they probably have a Kunai or something. So we're going to use it and pop that card. And we do get the Kunai, which is great. and they actually have another one. But that's not too bad for us. I mean, we do lose our double costing, and but at least we force them to use all their back row cards. So then when we do get Meteor Black Dragon, we're gonna be okay. So we drew another Summoner's Art. Perfect, perfect, really great, because we can get one of each now and basically get us for the game right here. Yeah, so search up the both Red Eyes Black Dragon or Meteor Dragon. And okay, so yeah, so I did mention that's why I want to hold off the Summoner's Arc, just in case you want to see what your top deck again. If you used it without knowing what you're going to get, it can go very backfire on you, and basically you won't be able to summon the Meteor Black Dragon. But thankfully we got two. So we were able to search both, and yeah, we're just going to bring out our Meteor Black Dragon right here, and swing in for game, because they have nothing to play. Otherwise, they have the Sphere Karibo, but I don't think so, and that is it, and we score game 3 right here. Yeah, they don't have any Sphere Karibos to protect them, so we do win that one. So, once again, hope you guys enjoyed this speed duel match duel right here. And if you guys do want to see that deck profile, you guys know what to do. It will always be out in a few days, so don't worry about that at all. And yeah, just so you guys keep in mind, and just so you guys know, this was a more of a fun casual duel session that we had. Nothing way too competitive. Like, these two decks are nowhere near the top tier list in the current format for speed duels, but it's always nice to have some casual duels and just for fun, right? I mean, like, Meteor Black Dragon's, like, iconic anime monster that you definitely want to summon, and Jirax, or, you know, they look very fun to play as well, because they were never that prominent in regular Yu-Gi-Oh! Either. So, yeah, that basically rounds us for this duel once again. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe to the Evolve channel for more awesome Yu-Gi-Oh! Speed Duel content on here. We focus mainly on Speed Duel, so if you guys like it, be sure to subscribe. Hit that like button. Comment down below what you guys think. Which kind of decks do you like more? Do you like it? Are you guys rooting for Meteor Black Dragon? Or are you guys rooting for Drac? Definitely let me know in the comment section down below. And yes, thank you guys so much for watching. As always, you guys have a great day. Great night, wherever you are. See you in the next video. And this is Evolve signing out.